Okay, welcome back. It's Thursday. Busy night tonight, 3 hours of radio coming your way, as it does every Monday through Friday. 60 guests a month. I think the total is over 23,000 now in all the years we've been doing this. I'm glad to have you with us this evening. We have, again, a deluge, an avalanche, a tsunami of news and information, which is now the number one spectator sport in these formerly United States. No question, we are in the news and information era. The trick is to wade through the propaganda and all the garbage that is being thrown at us by the mainstream media, which, again, you have to remember, only six corporations who are all operating on the same economic ethos and political philosophical bedrock are controlling over 95% of the media. They don't call it programming for nothing. Mind programming, that's what it's all about. If you come here, you know you're going to get reality, or as close a version of it as we can bring together. Let me say one quick thing, I'll get out of the way. I've told all of you listening this several times, and it's gotten worse in the last two or three days. I wake up multiple times at night with this feeling of dread. And I'm not a coward. I'm not saying that it's fear. It's a feeling of dark. It's foreboding. All right, how's that? And I'm very sick to see what's happening to our country. Makes me beyond ill. I think the two are connected.
They are. I mean, nothing like this has ever happened. And I've been doing this for 40 years. And in my wildest dreams of trend forecasting, I could never imagine anything so destructive as the COVID war launched by these politicians.
Sir.
And the devastation is spreading far and wide. This is unprecedented in world history. Could you imagine? I see little kids with, you know, masks on. They're telling morons, imbeciles, telling people not to hug and to kiss. I mean, this is sick. They're telling
children not to hug each other. It's child abuse.
Which human abuse? It's not only child abuse.
Of course.
You know, that you've got this little clown medical health person from Canada telling people not to have sex. And if you do, you should only do it with someone from your household, and you should wear. Then who the hell are you talking to? Who the hell are you? I'll tell you who the hell you are. This is satanic. It's a satanic takeover that has destroyed the human elements of life. And I'm saying this, and you get the magazine, the Trends Journal.
Oh, yeah.
We only put hard facts in there. And of course, the people that, you know, listen to, watch your shows and support you, they all know the facts. 94% of the people that contracted the disease had 2.6 pre-existing chronic conditions. Over 50% of the people that died around the world were elderly people from nursing homes. The first place it hit outside of China was Italy. The average age that they died was 81 years old. On and on and on and on and on. The facts are there. Nobody wants to know them. Nobody wants to see them. And as I said in the very beginning of this, they called it the COVID war. That's what they called it, all the media, all the politicians. And I said, just as the people hailed Hitler, marched to Mussolini, and saluted Stalin, they marched off to the COVID war. And you see adults walking down the streets with nobody around with masks on, driving in their cars with masks on, and making up little kids, kindergarten kids with masks on, getting their temperature taken by these freaks with shields and masks on called teachers. And I said to you on the last show, these are the same sick, power-hungry little freaks. They love their power. These little nothings of nobodies love to get power. These are the ones that had us hiding under desks in case an atom bomb went off.
I know. I know. It's really
as though that was going to make one bit of difference. These are the same people that are making up the crap. When you sit down and eat at the restaurant, whether it's inside or out, you don't have to wear the mask.
But
you stand up, then you've got to put the mask on. Who the hell are you talking to? And then if you're really a low-life, slimy piece of garbage crap, like that little piece of shit crap Newsom, and I'll say it to his face, Junior, he just came out the other day and said to people, when you're eating and drinking, put the mask on between drinking and eating. How sick can you be? How sick can you be? And where are all you cowards in California? Where are all you cowards in New York? Where are all you cowards in Michigan, Ohio? Where are all you cowards in Pennsylvania and New Jersey? Why don't you stand up for your freedom? All aboard! Next train to Auschwitz. Don't argue. Don't ask questions. Put on that mask and get on board.
This is unbelievable.
It's unbelievable. They have sucked the joy out of life.
Let's go there in just a minute. Just to repeat for all of you who might not have understood that clearly, Comrade Communist Governor Newsom in Bolshevik California has ordered now that all members of any household that go out to eat must keep their masks on between bites. You take a bite,
you
put that damn mask on. No, you can't.
You can't make this crap up.
No.
And that little slimy little another low-life piece of crap, and I'll call anyone out to their face. Any politician, Cuomo, Gruesome Newsom, little Tommy Wolf over there, little puppy dog, little Murphy, any one of you guys, you come over to me and you try to put a mask on me. That's right. You come over and try to put a mask on me, man to man. Come on, let's go. No. Leave your little boys behind. You little guys with cojones smaller than a mothball. Leave your little goons behind, and you come over here and try to do it to me.
Comrade Newsom, when I saw that yesterday, Gerald, I if I had it within me to still laugh at some of this evil, I would laugh. I just said, this is satanic evil.
Satanic.
Oh,
it's
yes.
Satanic. I'm a warrior for the Prince of Peace. Oh, and people say, but Mr. Salenti, you said you'd, if somebody tried to put that on you, then you would beat the crap out of them. I didn't say that. I said, let them try it. And let me tell you this, too. If somebody breaks into my house, I'll blow their brains out. Now, that does not make me not a warrior for the Prince of Peace. Who has their right to take my life? And to make this clear, boys and girls, the Prince of Peace became violent and picked up a whip to drive the money changers out of the temple. Oh, yeah, the money changers, like the J.P. Morgan Chase crowd. Oh, yeah, like last week in the Trends Journal, we highlighted the story. Oh, they were only fined a little under $1 billion for rigging the precious metals market. Oh, yeah. Why should you get angry? Hey, guess what? Same money changers, just different names. Oh, and what happened to Christ after that? Hanging on the cross 3 days later after he calls out the banksters.
That's no coincidence, ladies and gentlemen, at all. And Gerald is right. And I want to also, next time you talk to Craig, Paul Craig Roberts, give him my regards and the regards of this audience. His writing has gotten to be better and better and better. He's become even wiser and showing less hesitance to tell it like it is. In the last couple years, he has just done extraordinary things with his writing. So please pass
that
along.
Oh, he's a great man.
Yes,
he's a great man. Yeah, we're good friends.
He's a man. I know you are. I know.
Yeah. No, he, when I had a, when I was doing seminars, you know, he was one of the speakers when we, when we launched the Occupy Peace.
That's right.
He was here.
Yeah.
And by the way, talking about seminars, you know, the greatest depression's begun. The social, economic, and geopolitical fallout of this COVID war. It's going to spread far and wide. It's unprecedented. So we're having
by design, Gerald. By plan, it's all planned.
Well, by plan or not, we're having. I'm having a webinar on October 21st, a Trend Vision Q&A webinar to help people prepare and prevail. So if they want to sign up, they could go to my website, trendsresearch.com, trendsresearch.com, because this thing is unprecedented. It's unprecedented. It's unprecedented. And so we're doing everything we can to help people.
The Great Reset is the money changers reformatting the entire damned planet. That's what it is. It's the same people. It's the international bank cartel. It's the people who run the money game. And I'm not naming any religions here. I'm just talking about the people that run the money game. Same. I don't. Some are Christians. Some are Jewish. Some are agnostic, atheists. I don't care. It's the money people that are doing this. They've had this agenda on their table for a long time. And they got, when they started rolling this out and they saw how little resistance there was and how people freaked out and how they dutifully went into lockdown for 6 months or whatever it was in some places and put their little masks on, and now they're putting their little masks on their little children, doing that's child abuse. It's going to damage those kids for life. And many of the older people are—they're working and they wear their masks in the car. They breathe in the car. They go to work 6-8 hours. And what's in that mask, Gerald? Bacteria begin to grow. They are self-inoculating their own bodies with bacterial pneumonia, and it's coming out in stories now. You don't want to wear these masks for more than a couple of hours. You're going to have to learn how to rotate them, put them out in the sunshine, spray them with colloidal silver, whatever you need to do, put them in an ozone tank. You don't wear these for 8 hours. That's my point. Don't do it. You're going to get sick.
That guy, that little slimy lowlife, when I was talking about that guy Fauci, he was on Comedy Central, one of those stupid shows, how he says that when he's... He wears the mask down below his chin. Oh, yeah. All that research shows how filthy that is for you, and that's what that clown boy does. No, this is unprecedented.
It's dangerous. Gerald, I'm telling you, the international cartel of communism, they're communists, they're Zionist Bolshevik communists. They are planting in our cities and our towns all over the country cells. I've gotten reports now from a number of people. Yeah, some weird people moved in around the street. They did it in my town. I saw it. I happened to turn down the street. Coincidentally, I never go down the street. And there's a big moving van there, and they're unloading it into a two-story house. And the new people that are taking over the house are sitting in the yard. And one of them had this big Black Lives Matter banner right there in the yard. All right. It was an installation of a group.
I know. Look, I'm just saying, all I'm saying is people better stand up and fight for their freedom. Because if you don't, we're going to be living hell on earth.
Fight
we
for
already
their
are. That's right. You know, here, ready for this? People should stop kissing and consider wearing a mask when having sex to reduce your chances of being exposed to the novel coronavirus, according to Canada's top doctor. Dr. Theresa Tam, this was a few weeks ago, Canada's chief medical officer, laid out the sexual group rules, ground rules, during a statement. Quote, sexual health is an important part of our overall health. Who is she talking to? Who is she talking to? However, sex can be complicated in the time of COVID-19, especially for those, ready for this, especially those without an intimate partner. in their household.
Oh, especially for the, this woman's
especially
really,
for those.
What, she got two brain cells? She's
No. And she, remember, this is, this thing is written straight. You know, they didn't make fun of it. They're writing it as though it's real. She is Canada's top doctor.
Doctor.
Top,
read that last part again. Read that last part again. I got to hear that, please.
Sexual health is an important part of our overall health. However, sex can be complicated in a time of COVID-19, especially for those without an intimate partner in the household or whose sexual partner is at high risk for COVID-19. You ready? Here we go. If you choose to engage in an in-person sexual encounter, who is she talking to? Engage in an in-person sexual encounter? When have you ever,
I want to make this clear.
I love making love, and I never thought it as engaging in an in-person sexual encounter. You know, maybe this chick is into, maybe getting tied up and, who knows what she calls a in-person sexual encounter.
She's obviously she's a trisexual something or another.
Yeah,
Listen, if you choose to engage
in an in-person sexual encounter with someone outside your household...
I guess that means outside of a brother
or
sister. Are
you ready for this? Or close contacts bubble. There are some steps you can take to reduce your risk, Tam wrote. Tam, how about sham? How about piece of slimy crap? How about you ignorant, low-life moron? Oh, no, Salenti. She's a government official. You should obey her. I obey my government officials. Yeah. I believe in what my government tells me. I love Cuomo. I think Gruesome is wonderful. Oh, I'm a Murphy fan. How dare you not obey your governors? What's wrong with you? She added, she advised to skip kissing, avoid face-to-face contact, and consider using masks to cover your nose and mouth. I'm not making this up. This shows you the level of sickness, the satanic sickness that has taken over our world.
Yeah, it is. It is Luciferian satanic sickness. And you don't have to be religious to figure that out.
It has nothing to do with religion.
How are we going to actually promulgate the species under this kind of psychosis?
Could you imagine being a young kid?
How are kids supposed to learn about hormones rushing through your body?
When the only thing you want to do when you're young is to fall in love. And all those songs they used to have about it. No more of those songs. No more falling in love. You're in college now. You stay in your dormitory. You do not go out and sing. You do not go out to bars. You will not have concerts. You will not be able to go to football games and sit next to your friends. Get back in your dormitory.
Oh, well,
yes, sir. Yes, sir. All aboard. Next train to Auschwitz.
We'll do it. That's true.
You will do it. We're on the global plantation of Slavelandia.
Plantation Earth. That's right. That's what they want.
Slavelandia.
They want to reduce
the population
and have a plantation planet.
Yep. Take it easy, Black Lives Matter. We're all on the plantation now. Oh, and by the way, talking about Black Lives Matter, I'm going to be launching Italian Lives Matter. And I'm going to tell you why. And this isn't a joke. I have in my Jizzy book that you got many years ago, I wrote about, was Columbus in the Mafia? You know, it's okay to have all these shows on, like The Goodfellas and Sopranos and Godfather. Let me tell you, what are you doing? It blows brains out. I don't want to hear it anymore. Oh, you could do that about Italians, huh? Okay, bring back Amos and Andy. Oh, you don't remember that one, young people? Well, it was a great show, made a lot of people laugh, at black actors. Bring back that one, Black Lives Matter. Oh, I insulted you? I want every, I want all the, I want to see the show on with the Jewish thieves. Yeah, the banksters. Why, Salenti, you're anti-Semitic. No. I'm saying if you're going to stereotype the Italians, I want to stereotype the Jews. I want to stereotype the blacks. I want to stereotype the Latinos. If you could stereotype my nationality, you little low-life piece of crap, don't you tell me that it's okay to be disrespectful to Italian Americans, but you're better than we are? I want every show off. I don't want Netflix. I don't want anybody to be able to run any of those movies, any of those TV shows. It is anti-Italian.
Bravo. Bravo. I'll join. I'm there.
I'm moving on this.
I've had it.
Oh, look at those pizza boxes. Oh, you took Aunt Jemima and Uncle Ben off the things? I want all those Italian guys on the pizza boxes that are really fat with that big mustache and that stupid hat on and that are overweight. I want them off all the pizza boxes. If you got Uncle Ben off the rice, I want them off the pizza boxes.
Well said. Amen to that. Great. We got to have it. It's got to happen.
People better start fighting.
No, they have to fight. All lives matter or no lives matter. Okay? It's real simple. It's real simple. It's not a mystery.
With Satan in charge, no lives matter.
Oh, no, that's good. I got to remember that. On the planet Satan, no lives matter. And that's true.
It's not mine original. I'll send you the guy who did the artwork. And it was his, so I don't want to take credit for it.
Okay. All right. Please do. Stand by, and Gerald Salenti and I will be right back as we watch this incredible destruction of life as we knew it, purposely being aided and abetted by moron, idiot citizens of this very country. And it's not just here, it's all around the world. Hold on, we'll be right back. A few headlines, Gerald. Michelle Obama, the former freshman linebacker at Oregon State University, named Michael Robinson back in the day, its message to blacks is suppress your abilities and dreams and progress by donning victimhood status. She actually said that.
And who said this?
One. Who? Michelle Obama. Michael Robinson.
Oh, God. Oh, yeah. God.
Yeah. It's a tranny. Okay. God bless Joan Rivers. She said it, and then she was dead within 2 weeks. Elementary school kids are being taught that, get this one now, objectivity and perfectionism are racist traits of white supremacy.
Who said that?
Being taught in schools. Let me pull it up. It came from Summit News. Let me read it. Hold on. Children at an elementary school in Virginia are being taught that traits such as objectivity and perfectionism are racist characteristics of white supremacy. It's happening in Virginia. Belvedere Elementary School, Virginia. Here's the sign. 15 characteristics of white supremacy culture. They're teaching this to our little children. 15
yep.
characteristics
oh,
of
over,
white
man.
Supremacy culture.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Get this. Perfectionism. A sense of urgency. Defensiveness. Quantity over quality. Worship of the written word. Holy crap. I'm using a magnifying glass so I can read this. It's a little tough. We could go down these again. Perfectionism, sense of urgency, defensiveness, quantity over quality, worship of the written word. It's a characteristic, Gerald, of white supremacy. and that there's only one white way. What the hell does that say? Paternalism. Either or thinking. Either or. So open-mindedness, either or thinking, is a characteristic of white supremacy.
Of course it is.
Power hoarding. Fear of open conflict. A fear of open conflict. A fear of open conflict. A fear of rioting, going riot, is a characteristic of white supremacy. I can't read. These are too hard. Oh, here's one. Uh-oh. Objectivity, Gerald. Objectivity is a characteristic of white supremacy.
No, you have to believe what you're told. You should not be objective.
No thinking. You just
no,
react.
Not allowed.
You do not
no,
pro. No,
no
proactiveness. You react or you're toast. All right, now, that's really something. I got to go back to this other one I just had up there. This isn't, you know, American womanhood has been destroyed by feminism. That was a CIA op. We know that now. They're just destroyed. There are very few American women who have the old values, especially Generation Z. I've seen too many videos of these young women, or whatever they are, beating the hell out of other women, acting like guys, just like men. Now, here's another example of hatred of men through the words of an MSNBC host. Her name is Nicole Wallace. She was referring to Mike Pence's debate performance last night. And here are the words she used. Now, this is hatred of men. Make no mistake about it. She said his performance was flaccid. He looked limp and lame. This is anti-male. So this is where it's everywhere now. It's lurking, it's subconscious, subliminal, it's in your face, it's all over the map. He was flaccid and looked limp. This is an MSNBC host.
Yeah, and if you called, if you said that, what's her name, Harris, was arrogant and nasty,
oh, yeah,
then
you'd
be sexist.
You'd be a misogynist. Oh, yeah,
right.
A woman hater.
Oh, by the way, how did she get her, how did she, you know, get to the top? Who was he? Who
That's
was
right.
The guy she was having an affair with when he was married?
Willie Brown.
Willie Brown, yeah, Willie Brown. Yeah, yeah. Ah, the whole thing's a freak show. What a joke it was. There were like two high school kids. What a disgusting little spectacle the whole thing was. They were like children. It's still in high school. That's what this is. That's all this is. We're still in high school. These are the same people you hated in high school and college that wanted to be class president.
It's regressed. It's reverted.
Yeah,
it's gone back.
These are stupid children.
They're rewinding everything. Did Kamala Harris, the camel, have an extramarital affair with Willie Brown? Well, Willie says so. He described it in great detail. So
yep.
I say, Ho Harris humped her way to the top. The camel.
There's photos of her and him, and they're kind of embracing a little bit from what I remember.
I don't know. You're right. It's such a freak show.
It's
so
a joke.
Incredible.
It's a joke. How can anybody believe these clowns? And again, you know, it's one after. By the way, you know, I have to tell you, this is, you know, just, you know, the new magazine. You know, I've never worked so hard in my life. The new magazine, you know, we're putting out like between 60 to 70 pages a week. You know, no ads. And
no, the Trends Journal is what journalism used to be. It's what Time Magazine might have been 60, 70 years ago. Except
and you know today, you know, today I wanted to see what the media said about the debates, right? And I realized as I start looking, everyone took their political slant. You don't get any good reporting. So the point I wanted to make, and this is for listeners of the show, is that First of all, you know, the magazine, the Trends Journal, was the first to call Trump a winner in May of 2016 when he was behind in the polls. I still don't have him counted out. And I'll tell you why. And the cover of the magazine says it. Last week's, not this week's. Masks versus no masks. And that's what this is going to be about. And Trump has to win the swing states. And in order to do so, he has to get out the vote in the rural areas, particularly, in heavy numbers.
Correct.
And they're not mask wearers.
The 50% of America who didn't vote last time have got to vote this time.
I'm sorry, what'd you say?
The 50% of American voters who didn't vote in 2016 have got to get off their asses and vote.
Well, again, I'm not saying they should or shouldn't, but you're making the point that a lot of people didn't vote. The other thing is that the Republican, from what I've been told, and I've been from a very reliable source from somebody he read it from, is that in places like Pennsylvania and Florida, a number of states, the Republican new registrations are much higher than the Democrats. So all Trump has to do is to win the swing states, and it's going to be against lockdowns versus no lockdowns, masks versus no masks. Number two, and this is big, so everyone, again, I don't give financial advice. If the Democrats win, this is going to be great for gold because they're going to pump more cheap money into the system, even more than Trump administration.
Non-existent money.
Non-existent money. You saw the debt is bigger than the money we made this year.
Of course.
Yeah. So, again, when they started the year off, it was, oh, my God, we're going to have a $1 trillion debt. Now it's up to over $3 trillion. So, but the Democrats will even make it worse. They'll pump more cheap money in. That's going to bring the dollar down in gold prices.
They'll also take us to war. There. Every war we've ever gone into.
We're going to war. That's why I'm angry. And I'm against war. War is, when you go to war, you lost already. You avoid war at every cost.
Right. Who makes money in war? The money changers. They all do. The bankers. They all do.
All the time.
Somebody's got to finance that. All right, here's more now. 22% of gun-owning households in America have obtained a new firearm since the Antifa BLM communist riots began. 22%, one out of five homes, picked up another firearm for defense. These are defensive weapons. 20%, this is a big one, Gerald, 20% of all Americans could be out of money, broke, empty wallets by Election Day.
And that's what I said to you.
One out of five. Yeah?
I also think there's going to be a stimulus package before Election Day.
Well,
they're going to keep pumping money into the system.
Right.
And it's going to bring down the value of the dollar. It's bringing down the value of all the currencies.
Total inflation.
But, yeah, total inflation. And this is kind of Weimar Republic days. So,
yes.
Again, I will put my trend forecasting record on gold and silver up against anybody's. As you well know, I've called every shot. In June, when silver was down to $17 an ounce, we said silver prices are going to spike at a higher percentage rate than gold. And again, back then it was, you know, $17 and change. As we speak now, it's $24.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Gold, when I was on last June of 2019, on June 6th, we sent a trend alert to our subscribers. Gold was $1,332 an ounce. As we speak now, it's $1,900 an ounce. Remember, it was $1,332. Now it's $1,907. So what I'm saying to everyone listening is prepare and prevail for the greatest depression that's underway. And again, we're having a webinar, and I'm going to take questions and answers, on April October 21st, a couple of weeks from now, and you can go to trendsresearch.com, and you can get the information you need to sign up.
Good. All right. Riots in Madison, Wisconsin. They're out again in the streets, throwing rocks through windows, breaking storefronts, just doing it. This is a random... This is not a random thing. They want you to believe it is. This is part of a nationwide operation. They're going to hit city after city after city with the same...
We have them up here. We have them in Kingston. The Antifas are up here.
In Kingston?
No. And you know what? And you know what? Somebody sent me something. I'll see if I could find it. They said that Warren Buffett is behind this, Antifa. Have you heard about that?
Not Buffett, only Soros.
Huh? Nope, and on the Antifa, and that's what I heard. I don't.
I'd
again,
sure like
you know,
to know,
they sent me. They,
He ought to be fried if he is. Wow. Here's another one. This is big site. The food supply chain.
Here it is.
Chain.
I just. Okay. Here, wait. This is here. Warren Buffett, Berkshire Hathaway, linked to Antifa online, and you know who this is from? Business Insider.
Mm-hmm.
No, Bloomberg. Bloomberg. Google it up, anybody. Put Antifa and put in Buffett.
I'm going to do this right now. So that's a Bloomberg story. Okay.
And just put in Antifa. Go to Google, put Antifa and Buffett. B-U-F-F-E-T-T.
Warren Buffett, Berkshire Hathaway. There it is. This story came out on June 13th.
And somebody just sent it to me.
Man, that snuck under the radar. Britt Stokes saw the first baffling tweet Monday, June the 1st. It showed two images of bricks stacked with a delivery tag from the Acme Brick Company, where Stokes is director of marketing. The Twitter post suggested the company left the bricks intentionally to be used in protests in San Francisco, or Frisco, rather, a Dallas, Texas suburb. Da 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 da. Where I'm looking for Buffett. You're gonna go down a ways. Where is it? Acme Brick. Here it is. Was an easy target for the conspiracy-minded. Acme Brick, Warren Buffett's company, bought the Fort Worth, Texas-based business in the year 2000. Bill Gates sat on the Berkshire Hathaway board until his announcement in March that he'd step down, a fact that web sleuths glommed onto. Gates is at the center of conspiracy theories about coronavirus. Subsequent media reports and fact-checking organizations found no evidence of coordinated efforts to blah, blah, plant bricks, da-da-da. I'm looking for more. Here you go.
There's more to it than that, though. There's other stuff saying that... there was this woman who worked. I know it was Black Lives Matter.
I see it. I see it. Hold on. I see it. YouTube and other technology platforms banned Alex Jones in 2018. Jones said that Acme Brick is owned by Berkshire Hathaway. La da 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 da. Okay, but another YouTube user uploaded his June show. This is Jones. The clip isn't particularly popular. Yet another one is a video of an anonymous woman stating matter-of-factly that Acme Brick delivered pallets of bricks to rioters and Antifa. She names Buffett, Gates, and the Pritzker family, which sold a manufacturing business, Marmon Holdings, to Berkshire Hathaway starting in 2008. Versions of the 30-second clip have been viewed over 700,000 times on YouTube. So there's that woman.
Here's another one. If you put in Black Lives Matter Buffett, okay. 2 days ago, is Warren Buffett the wallet behind Black Lives Matter?
Oh. If Buffett turns out to be one of the big communist Bolshevik traitors, that'd be interesting. To say the least. Here it is. Is Warren Buffett the wallet behind Black Lives Matter?
Yep.
Okay. Yeah, this looks like a pretty good story.
Yep. Yep.
Oh, this guy's dirty. He's dirty. Yeah. Okay, thanks for that. Wow. Well, let's put Warren Buffett in the same sentence with George
Soros.
And
all you Bisonos out there, you know, Italian lives matter. And if they could do this to Italians and make us look like cafones and mobsters, yeah. I want all these shows off the air. I want them going the same way that Amos and Andy went. This is a disgrace to Italian Americans.
Wonderful program, Amos and Andy. You can see it on YouTube.
They were funny.
I've scrubbed it. Funny, funny
guys. Oh, no, it's
gone. Gone, long gone. Okay.
Gone. But you can have them all.
You can't see.
You know, hey, let me tell you, I'm happy to be on your show, you know? Hey, you're a good guy. I like you.
We are.
We're all like that. You know, there was no such thing as the Renaissance. There's no such thing as fine Italian cuisine.
Or Verdi.
Oh, Gucci? Oh, you mean the Stone Verdi? Yeah. Michelangelo, Da Vinci, Puccini? Oh, no. No, they don't count. They don't count all the luxury items that come from Italians. No, we're just this is who we are. We'll blow your brains out. Come over here.
Well, I agree. You know, there's some really wonderful black actors in Hollywood history that you younger people don't even know about. You'll never know about. One was Mantan Moreland. He was in all the Charlie Chan movies. Another one was Willie Best.
Yep.
Willie Best was another one. These guys were really comic geniuses. And then Bojangles.
How about this one? How about America's greatest export? Music, jazz, from Jelly Roll Morton, ragtime, swing time, to Count Basie. Yeah, Count Basie, Duke Ellington. The Black Cats were the hippest ones around. Every cool guy wanted to be like them. Look at the music that they put out. The Louis Armstrongs, the Ella Fitzgeralds. By the way, when I was the number two guy running a trade association back in the 70s, we had Ella Fitzgerald perform in front of our group. I went backstage with her, you know, afterwards, and she told my former wife, may she rest in peace, that she reminded her of her goddaughter Carmen. The quality, the style of an Ella Fitzgerald. Again, all of these guys, one after another, they were it. They rock and roll. That's where the soul came from. Rhythm and blues. It was them. It was people. They look at them. Look at the music. The Cab Calloway, one after another. And then it went out to rap.
They killed music. That's not music.
It's not music.
It's product. No, it's product.
Yeah, so anyway, Black Lives Matters. Every hip cat wanted to go the black route when the music was the hottest and they were the hippest. They set the dress style. They were it. Was there discrimination? Yes. Was there ignorance? Yes. And I want to make this clear to everybody listening. America is not a racist nation. A racist nation does not elect a Barack Obama. A racist nation does not have
Twice.
A criminal like Colin Powell, who that little crap of Colin, yeah, that's what goes down the colon, who sold us the Iraq War to in the United Nations.
Mine.
How about
Mine.
Condoleezza Rice, the next mushroom cloud you see? Oh, yeah, and how about that Susan Rice? Yeah, I want that guy Gaddafi out of there. Oh, what color were they? Why, Salenti, you're being racist. Good, bad, and ugly comes in all races, creeds, and colors. say, don't want to hear it anybody. Oh, by the way, the selection of Kamala Harris is sexist and racist. I'm in business. I want the best person I could have doing my job. I could care if they're black, white, green, yellow, upside down, transgender, inside out. I want the best person. And now hear this, all you political freaks. There's a word, public servants. You work for me. I want the best person in the job, not the person that you think is going to bring your ratings up.
Right. Right, right.
I want the best person to do the job, save your color, race, creed, don't want to hear it.
Here's an example of black American music. Not black music, black American music.
Only you can make all this world seem right. Only you can make the darkness bright.
You get the idea. You think any of those rappers have one iota, one micro ounce of talent compared to that? Forget it.
I forgot about the other. Oh, then there was Nat King Cole, and there was one after another.
Well, you just heard one, Tony.
Ray Charles. How about Ray Charles? Yeah. I saw Ray Charles. I saw him twice, actually.
Yeah.
I saw Lionel Hampton. I saw him too.